Hey, Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in. And today I want to talk about a study on the well-known herb ginger. This is something that's been used for medicinal purposes in both Ayurvedic, which is Indian, and Asian Chinese medicine for thousands of years, and is seen to be a potent anti-inflammatory herb. So this randomized placebo-controlled trial, a really good quality trial in the same vein as you would test drugs. This one published in the International Journal of Food Science and Nutrition the end of last year, looked at ginger in patients with diabetes. So what they did is they took 63 people with diabetes. They were overweight or obese, and they did not have well-controlled diabetes. Their blood sugar levels were high, their hemoglobin A1Cs were between 7 and 10, which indicates not good blood control. And what they did is they gave them for 12 weeks 1600 milligrams of ginger, taken 800 milligrams after lunch and 800 milligrams after dinner, and they gave them that for 33 of the people, and for 30 they gave them a sugar pill. Not really sugar though, obviously, a placebo pill with nothing in it. And what they found at the end of 12 weeks was that the blood sugar was reduced by 9 points, but more remarkably, that A1C, that average drop in blood sugar over 3 months, was reduced by an entire 1%. That is levels you would see, ladies and gentlemen, in someone taking a prescription drug for diabetes. They also showed significant reductions in inflammation. And one of the things we think is that diabetes may also be connected to inflammation. And so reducing inflammation may be important. So my take on this is that ginger is an incredible herb and something to certainly look at, not just for inflammation, but potentially for the treatment of diabetes. Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in.